there, Mackie, Dave Mackie Engineering. Shout out to you guys. Shout out to Monty. Monty does all my work. I've had this building there. This is a 107, and I just had Monty. I just didn't pick this up, actually. I'll pull it out here in a minute, but fucking dog here. What we have here is the S&S flywheel, and I had, it's not bobbed as far as the weight, but you know, it's just gonna rattle a little bit more, but hey, that's what we pay for, right? This is made for the 106-103. My bike is originally 103. These are forged pistons, so they are a little bit heavier, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong there, but I believe these Mackie pistons are a little heavier. So regardless, I would have had to send this thing over to Dark Horse. They would have had to take it apart, probably, you know, clean it all up. But you know, you can get like the pins, you can probably get lighter ones, but I'm not even gonna worry about it. All I know is I got the S&S in here, and I have the Timken conversion. So shout out to Dave Mackie. He put the, or not Dave himself, but shout out to fucking Monty. He put the Timken conversion in here for me. I appreciate it. And yeah, S&S flywheel. So now it's my turn. As far as price, well, the flywheel was already done up. I gave him a brand new flywheel in a box, so I think it was like $500, but it might have been a little bit more. So I bought some extra parts that goes on a couple other things, but it was about a $500 job to have him do the Timken conversion. And yeah, I'm cool with that. So the next thing is we're gonna be putting this thing together. So yeah, cover this bitch back up. And pretty soon this thing will be rolling. And I'll show you how we're actually doing it here. Now, if you guys are out there and you're gonna talk shit in the comments, well, I'm just gonna talk shit back. I don't care how you do your pistons. This is how I'm doing mine on my bike. Make your own video. This is gonna run like a beast. It's gonna have like 115 pounds of torque, 110 horsepower or something like that, 118 pounds of torque, 110 horsepower, 113 horsepower, something like that. It's over 100, and that's fast. Before I use the screwdriver here, this time I'm just going to use a bigger grit sandpaper like I am now. So then it won't make the indentions like I had there before. I know, this is fucking boring as shit. This is what's going on. You might go on the internet and you're looking for a fast way to clean a piston, unless you have a water blaster or something safe, bead blaster of some sort. Well, hard work is the only way that's gonna get the shit off. These circular motions, I feel like it gets it off the best, and it's like a machine, you know, it's like a cross hatch on the inside of your walls on the jugs, you know, you don't want it to be flat, so I just roll it. But see, I mean, these are sharp edges, you want to keep those sharp. This is damn near all clean right here, and it's still sharp, so keep these sharp, your edges sharp, best as possible. And I switched over to the other sandpaper now. Camera's probably moving right now, I'm sorry guys. I need to put a different station for the camera up top here. I will have to move it. But fucking hard work. Start posting this on YouTube. This is a 20-minute video. Instead of cutting it, I should just do different parts. If I had to give tips on this, if you have a water blaster somewhere nearby, pay them to fucking blast this shit and clean it for you, as long as it doesn't do nothing to your piston. If you have a mineral spirit tank, clean it up yourself. Wire brush, brass one, and polish it up afterwards with different size sandpaper all the way to, you know, 3000 in polishing if you really care. Me, this is just quick job, and I'm gonna hit it with 1000 after, and then new piston, new rings in it, and we're ready to roll. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do here, and I'm gonna end up uploading this. I appreciate you guys stopping by. Please like, subscribe this shit, share it with your friends, excuse my language, and yeah, watch the rest of this. So we're doing this whole build, like I said, Dave Mackey shop, shout out to them. This is their 107 Megasphere, and it kicks out over 100 horsepower. So on my bike, it's pumping. So I don't know the exact numbers, but anyways, back to it. And they probably wouldn't condone any of this shit. They're clean professionals. Monty is the man over there, and he runs a tight fucking schedule over there. If your bike sits there for more than a couple weeks, it's only because of the fucking parts. Alright? Monty's a fucking man. So this is the 107. They got the 110, or the one, the 110. They got the 110, and I'm sure they got some other builds too. But I know the 110, they have to take the bottom end and bore it out with some shit. So I just wanted the 103 when I originally did this, because my bike was already a 103, and my buddy has the 103 in his. Like a 06 FXD, and that fucking thing is snappy as fuck. But I know what's going on with my bike. It's always been good. It likes to go really fast, but at low speeds, it like at stoplights, it doesn't like it. So I figured, I think Monty told me exactly what was going on with my bike, which was exactly what's going on, was it's hesitating, something to do with something or another, and you know, I changed my fuel pump and all kinds of other shit. Well, it's my fucking Power Commander. I have a Power Commander 5 or whatever on there, and it will do that. So you know, performance, you feel everything, you know, when if you ride for performance, you feel it. If you don't really know what you're feeling, then you probably don't care, but say, is this politically correct to clean your pistons like this? Bro, this is all I got in my garage right now. I don't even care. Do I care if it's in my bike, you're asking? Well, of course I do. Why do you think I put a S&S fucking flywheel on there? I'll tell you what happened. I pulled out in front of one of my friend's house, seeing him up on the porch smoking a cigarette. Excuse me, sorry. I was just doing 80 off the road on the freeway. Come off with one hand, just chilling. I'm not gonna be riding with one hand anymore, that's dumb. I come right there, and I see him, and I fucking drop it. Second gear, and I go to throw a wheelie, and my fucking clutch basket just explodes, and a piece of my clutch basket gets stuck inside the chain, and my bike just completely locks up, and I skid for days. And then I pull the clutch in, skid, pull the clutch in, skid, pull the clutch in, skid. I think I did it 4 times because I was trying to, you know, get my bike to fucking start back up or act right. So of course I was on the clutch like that. And I did it a few times. I tried to, you know, try to pop it, you know. Anyways, that didn't work. Had one of the little homeboys fucking run me back to my homeboy's house right there. There's people running out of the house like Fuck, you're drinking, fucking put your bike in my garage. This is good neighborhood. But anyways, so it fucking, I haven't rode my bike since then. And what happened was, when that, the last time I measured it, my flywheel runout was like 4,000, like 4 or 5,000. It was like 14,000 this time. And this is from locking up. So in my head, I'm like, okay, something's up with my flywheel. I could take it out, put the pin in, do all that shit. How much am I gonna spend at the very end of it? Okay, fuck it. I'm just gonna grab the fucking SNS flywheel. Excuse my language. Excuse my language. I need to learn, people. I need to learn. But just took it out of the washer. I don't know. I think it's good enough for me. 1,000 grit. I could have got nutty with, you know, a good 400, good 800, good 1,000, 15, 2, 25, 3,000, and buff it. If you guys do that, comment below. Let us know where it's at. I want to check it out. I like to see if somebody buff it out. But until then, this is what I got going on. And can't wait to start building this bike. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.